Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaiden of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh.
And dwelt in our midst.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, to pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness.
Come and let us adore him.
Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Come, let us adore him.
Psalms 41 and 52. Happy are they who consider the poor and needy. The Lord will deliver them in the time of trouble.
I will say to the God of my strength, why have you forgotten me? And why do I go so heavily while the enemy oppresses me?
The Lord sustains the man on the sick bed. And ministers to them in their illness.
Why are you so full of heaviness in my soul? And why are you so disquieted within me?
My enemies are saying wicked things about me. When will he die and his name perish?
Even if they come to see me, they speak empty words. Their heart collects false rumors, they go outside and spread them.
All my enemies whisper together about me and devise evil against me.
A deadly thing they say is fastened on him. He is taken to his bed and will never get up again.
Even my best friend, whom I trusted, who broke bread with me, has lifted up his heel and turned against me.
But you, O Lord, be merciful to me and raise me up, and I shall repay them.
By this I know you are pleased with me, that my enemy does not triumph over me.
In my integrity you hold me fast, and shall set before me before your face forever.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel. From age to age, amen, amen. You tyrant, why do you boast of wickedness? Against the godly all day long.
You plot ruin, your tongue is like a sharpened razor. O worker of deception.
You know the old war that you are under. And lie more than speaking the truth.
We love all words that hurt. O you deceitful tongue.
O that God would demolish you utterly, topple you and snatch you from your dwelling, and root you out of the land of the living.
The righteous shall see and tremble, and they shall laugh at him, saying,
This is the one who did not take God for a refuge, but trusted in great wealth and relied upon wickedness.
Thy might be green olive tree in the hands of God. I trust in the mercy of God forever and ever.
I will give you thanks for what you have done, and declare the goodness of your name in the presence of the God.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
is now, and will be forever. Amen. The book of Deuteronomy, the 11th chapter, beginning at the 13th verse. Moses summoned all Israel and said to them, "If you'll only heed my every commandment that I am commanding you today, loving the Lord your God and serving him with all your heart and with all your soul, then he will give the rain for your land in its season, the early rain and the later rain, and you will gather in your grain, your wine, and your oil, and he will give grass in your fields for your livestock, and you will eat your food. Take care, or you will be seduced into turning away, serving other gods and worshipping them, for then the anger of the Lord will be kindled against you, and he will shut up the heavens, so that there will be no rain and the land will yield no fruit. Then you will perish quickly off the good land that the Lord has given you. You shall put these words of mine in your heart and soul, and you shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and fix them as an emblem on your forehead. Teach them to your children, talking about them when you are at home and when you are away, and when you lie down and when you rise." The word of the Lord.
The song of Moses. I will sing to the Lord when his lofty and uplifted.
The horse of each rider has he hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him. The God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. Yahweh is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army have been hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. Your right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, work of wonders? You stretched forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love you led the people you redeemed. With your might you brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and plant them on the mount of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary of the Lord that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Second letter of Paul to the Corinthians, the 5th chapter, beginning at the 11th verse. Knowing the fear of the Lord, we try to persuade others, but we ourselves are well known to God, and I hope that we are also well known to your consciences. We are not commending ourselves to you again, but giving you an opportunity to boast about us, so that you may be able to answer those who boast in outward appearance and not in the heart. For if we are beside ourselves, it is for God. If we are in your right mind, it is for you. The love of Christ urges us on, because we are convinced that one has died for all, therefore all have died. And he died for all, so that those who live might live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised again. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view. Even though we once know Christ from a human point of view, we know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting to the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ, since God is making his appeal through us. We entreat you on behalf of Christ to be reconciled to God. For our sake he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, "At an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A song of God's children. The law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has
set us free from the law of sin and death. All who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For we have received the Spirit that enables us to cry, "Abba, Father." The Spirit himself bears witness that we are children of God. And if God's children, then heirs of God. If heirs of God, then fellow heirs with Christ. Since we suffer with him now, that we may be glorified with him. The sufferings that we now endure are not worth comparing to a glory that shall be revealed. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your will be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
O God, your never-failing providence sets in order all things both in heaven and earth. Put away from us, we entreat you, all hurtful things, and give us those things which we are profitable for us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, the King Eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, draw far from us all wrong desires, incline our hearts to keep your law, and guide our feet into a way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold, pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, he will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.